Okay. So thank you so much, Sir Pat, for your uplifting introduction. So once again, good afternoon, Pangarapians. Hello sa ating mga active viewers who are watching right now. So magandang hapon po. Keep safe sa lahat while watching. So the assigned topic for me is the seventh element of healthy habits, and that is keep good hygiene. Okay, so once again, I am Daisy De Bautista, your today's presenter. Okay, so let's just have a short wrap up on what my fellow MAPI teachers have been discussed under the healthy habits. So it had been discussed, choose nutritious and varied options, manage portions, choose to drink water, play actively, enjoy meals, and care for the planet, and lastly, keep good hygiene as my topic. Okay, so in choosing nutritious and varied options, you need to consider the vitamin content of the food you eat. So foods much better to be rich in vitamin A, C, B, of course, and zinc and iron. Okay, and then of course you need to manage portions, which shows here on the screens the plate of healthy diet or balanced diet from the category of the Go, Grow, and Glow food pyramid. Okay, so of course choose to drink water and milk. So it is better for you, for all of us, to choose, piliin po natin na mas uminom ng tubig po. Why? Dahil yung water po ay mag-cleanse ng ating body inside. Okay, lilinisin niya po ang ating katawan, course, at yan ay magpapawi ng totoong uhaw na nararamdaman natin. Okay, play actively, which is one of the main promotion of the Nestle wellness. So aside from the sports or games, you can also do some physical activities such as doing household chores. Okay, enjoying meals together with your lovely family at home. Okay, you need to cherish the time the bonding is spent together. And then of course, care for the planet. Of course, our Mother Earth now is longing for our care. We need to have a clean and green living. Of course, we need to practice the 3 R's. And what are those? We have the reduce, reuse, and recycle para iwas ng kalat at panganib sa ating nature. Ayan. Of course, my topic is all about keeping good hygiene. That involves 2 lessons. So the first lesson is all about hand washing, and the second one is personal hygiene. So later on, we're going to dig up what is hand washing is all about in personal hygiene. So microorganisms exist everywhere. That's true. Millions of bacteria pathogens are everywhere. Okay, so they are known as microscopic organisms. Why? Because we cannot see them in our naked eye. We need to use a microscope in order for us to see them. Of course, they can't be seen, as what I have said, they cannot be seen with the naked eye, but can be easily transferred from objects and surfaces to the people or from one person to another. Of course, ayan, napakadali po nilang may transfer. Okay, sa pamamagitan kaya ng ano, what is the most part of our body that can transmit that those microorganisms that we have mentioned earlier? Okay, microorganisms can cause sickness, and that is really a fact. Why? In our present pandemic situation, where coronavirus is spreading all throughout globally, kaya nga tinawag na pandemic. Okay, so young viruses na yan that will enter our body can cause sickness. Lahat ng sakit maranasan natin once na yung bacteria, microorganism, viruses, pathogens ay pumasok na sa katawan natin. Okay. So, the most part of our body that transmit microorganisms from one person to another, to one place to another, and so on, is our hands, of course. So, when to wash your hands? We need to know when is the right time for us to wash our hands. Of course, there is before, during, and after preparing food. So, of course, in the preparation of food, we need to see to it that our hands are clean. Okay. Before eating food. Of course, especially to those people who love to eat food in their bare hand, yung mga nagkakamay. So, kailangan panatiling malinis ang kamay. And then, other one is after sneezing and coughing. After mong bumahing or umubo. Do you know what pangarap yan? Na whenever handkerchief or towel, face towel or tissue paper is not around, you can use your sleeves. Ayan, yung sleeves ninyo ang gamitin ninyo para bahingan. Kasi kapag kamay ninyo ang ginamit ninyo once na kayo bumahing or umubo, prone na lahat ng mga bakteriyang galing sa bibig ninyo, sa binahing ninyo ay mapupunta po dyan. Of course, next is before and after caring for a sick person. Especially common to the hospital areas or clinics that attending sick people. So, once you are done with your work attending ill people, say to it that you need to wash your hands. If you do really love your family, even yourself, because you will be the one to bring the viruses or bacteria at home. So, say to it to wash your hands, okay, frequently. When to wash your hands again? After using toilet. Ayan. After yung gumamit ng palikuran. Hindi tama yung punas-punas lang, wisik-wisik lang. Siguraduhin, hugasan ng mabuti ang kamay. And of course, yung after touching money. Do you know that the money is being circulated globally, locally, nationally, because it is being used by all. Okay? So, as means of buying foods or paying something. Ayan. So, lahat yan, mapabarya, mapapapelman, yan ay dumaan sa iba't ibang tao, sa iba't ibang kamay, at kung sino-sino man. Okay. So, hindi natin malalaman na malinis. O talagang, let us accept the fact na yung pera ay madumi. Okay. So, of course, after touching animals and or animal waste. Ayan. Kung naglinis tayo ng dumi ng mga animals natin, pet natin, see to it na ugaliing maghugas ng kamay. Okay? Then, after touching garbage or dirty dishes. Ayan. Syempre, basura nga, di ba? So, basura means yan ay madumi. Okay. So, ugaliin nating hugasan ang ating mga kamay after touching, after natin magtapon ng basura. Baliwanag po. Okay. And now, let us identify the proper hand washing procedures. So, it is not just simply ng paghuhugas ng kamay with just the use of water only. So, we need to apply soap and create a thick lather for about 20 seconds. Paano ba natin mo-monitor na yung ating paghuhugas ng kamay or paghasabon ng kamay natin is nasa 20 seconds na? We need to sing a happy birthday song that will last for 20 seconds. Okay. Next is we need to rub our palms together while intertwining our fingers like this. Okay. Wherein the interlocking part of our fingers there wherein the bacteria are residing there in the interlocking part of our fingers. So, need to rub it carefully. Okay, next is to rub the back of your fingers and the fingertips against the opposite palm, like that. And do the same on the other hand. Okay. Next is to grasp the thumb and rub it with rotating motion. So you need to hold this one and then rub like this. Okay. And do the same thing on the other thumb. Okay, like that. And then rub one palm against at the back of the other palm, like this. And vice versa. And then, you need to rinse your hands with a clean running water. Why running water? Because of the stagnant water there you are using, hindi mo masabing clean kasi nga pinagbanlawan mo na. So, lahat ng dumi ay nandun sa plangkana. See to it na it is a running water coming from the faucet. Okay? Okay ba yung pangarap yan? And then, of course, we need to air dry your hands. So, we do not sure that microorganisms are also exist on cloth towel. So, we are not sure if the towel is so clean. So, after washing your hands, it is better to air dry them. Syempre, yung ibang magagamit nating towel, face towel, or hand towel, paper, tissue, ay malinis. So, see to it na para talagang masecure natin, na wala nang duming kakapit sa atin, is you need to air dry, even sa gamit lang ng electric fan, kung wala yung katulad ng sa mga mall na air drying. Okay. And then, in the absence of water, clean water and soap, there is a hand sanitizers. Okay. But it doesn't mean po na hand sanitizer is much better than hand washing. No. If you are not able to immediately wash your hands with soap and water, you can use hand sanitizer that contains at least 60% of the alcohol, which also helps to kill microorganisms. But remember, sanitizers cannot remove all the types of microorganisms. Hand washing is still the best if your hands are visibly dirty and soiled. So sometimes, diba, nagdi-deal tayo like sa gardening. So, yung kamay natin sa lagang nadudumihan. So, it is not enough kung hand sanitizers ang ginagamit. But hand sanitizer is much better compared to alcohol itself. Why? Alcohol, ang disadvantage niya, it will dry the skin. Okay? It will dry the skin. Pero yung hand sanitizers, aside from it keeping your hands clean and free from any germs, is namo-moisturize niya pa ang iyong kamay. Yun po ang ingredients na meron sa hand sanitizers. Okay? Okay. So, next lesson is all about personal hygiene. And what is personal hygiene when you heard the word personal hygiene? It is referred to practices that you can do to take care of your own health by keeping your body clean and your surroundings sanitize. So, aside from keeping your body clean, yung paligid pa natin ay napapaniliti nating malinis. Okay. So, what are those practices? Of course, number one dyan is taking a bath. So, you should take a bath every day, especially after sweating or if you get dirty. Syempre, pag nadumihan ka, kailangan maligo ka para matanggal yung dumi. And of course, after mo magpapawis, maglaro, di ba, ng sports like basketball, volleyball, and so on, mabilad sa araw, is magpahinga ng panandalian for minutes, and then you need now to take a bath para lahat nung naiwan na natuyong mga pawis sa mga underarms ninyo or even sa mga kasingit-singitan ay talagang totally mawala. Okay. Germs and bacteria love sweat and dirt. So if you do not wash off sweat or dirt on your body, the germs and bacteria will quickly multiply bacteria and sweat also. That causes body odor. Totoo. That's why at their ages, diba? Kapangarapin, kayo ay nasa junior high school. You are already teenager, adolescents. So you are experiencing this kind of changes, physical changes. Somewhat, meron na kayong naaamoy na maasim-asim sa katawan ninyo. Okay, so with that, it is better for you to take a bath. So, what are the things that you need to remember when taking a bath? Okay, use soap and clean water. Okay, soap your armpits, genitals, and feet thoroughly. Kailangan kuskusin nyo ng sabon ang inyong mga kilikili, armpit singit, para totally matanggal yung mga bakteriyang na namamahay doon. Kasi nga doon sila sa pawisin ng areyang part na yun, mas gustong-gusto nila sa mga moist areas, sa mabasa-basa. At mas mabilis sila mag-multiply doon. So, use a clean towel to dry your body and avoid sharing soap and towels which are considered as your personal things or belongings. Kailangan yung sarili ninyong gamit ay pang sarili lamang. Care for your scalp and hair. To properly wash your hair, scalp, you should wet your hair thoroughly, basain ng mabuti, use right amount of shampoo, massage your scalp well to remove dead skin cells. Yung dead skin cells na yan, yun yung mga kaspa o dandruff na meron kayo sa hair natin or sa scalp natin. So, situ-ito imamassage natin na hindi lamang pagsabon ng ganyan, imamassage po natin. Then, rinse until you don't see any more bubbles or soap sags in your hair. Dry your hair, head with clean towel again. So, it is important not to share towels, combs, and brushes. Why? You should not share towels, comb, brushes, or even hair accessories to avoid the spread of head lice or nits. Ayan. Syempre, yung mga lisa o yung mga lice na yan, kuto, once na nagpahiram kayo ng suklay or any ipit, headband, and so on, na ginagamit nyo sa ulo ninyo, possible na pwede po kayo mahawaan na magkaroon na rin kayo ng head lice. Ayan. So, careful for that. Hindi tayo sa nagdadamot, nag-aalaga lang tayo ng tama sa pangatawan natin. Keeping ourselves free from any microorganisms. Okay ba yung pangarap yan? Okay, next is to brush your teeth. The best way to prevent tooth decay is to brush your teeth with toothpaste that contains fluoride. Ayan, not enough yung mga asin-asin lang. Need to brush your teeth with toothpaste. Ayan, here's the proper way to brush your teeth. Squeeze a pea-sized amount of toothpaste onto the toothbrush. Kung gaano ka lang yung toothbrush ninyo, yun din yung dami, maximum. Pwedeng half ng sukat or size ng inyong toothbrush. Brush all teeth, especially the molars in the back, for at least 2 minutes. Ayan ha, 2 minutes po yung molar ninyo. Molar in the back para matanggal lahat ng dumi. Spit the toothpaste out. But do not rinse your mouth. Okay, huwag mo nang mumugan. Idurahin nyo lang yung sa toothpaste ninyo, napagbrushan ninyo. Pero huwag nyo munang irarinse yung mouth ninyo. Okay, use your hand and some water to wipe your mouth. Syempre may mga naiiwan dito sa gilid, di ba? So, kailangan tayong gumamit ng kamay natin para iwas yung ating mouth. Then, rinse your toothbrush with clean water before placing it back to its proper place. Ayan. Tama? Okay. So, cut your fingernails. Ayan. That is one thing to consider in keeping yourself free from any microorganisms. So, are your fingers dirty? Are they long? So, take note for that. Kung yan ay mahaba at hindi nyo kayang i-maintain or alagaan, next is cut your fingernails. Are your fingernails dirty? Are they long? Okay. See to it if you notice that your fingers are too long enough na hindi mo na po kayang linisin or hindi mo ma-maintain. Diba? See to it na you need to cut your fingernails now. Ayan. You should be cutting your nails short enough following the shape of the nail para iwas din yung pagsiksik ng mga dumi sa kuko na dyan tumiksiksik yung mga bakterya. What if ginamit mo pa yung hands mo para sa pagkain sa pagsubo ng kanin? Diba? So, it is better for you to check your fingernails. Okay? So, Keeping nails trim is important to maintaining your health. Ayan. Panatilihing mali sa ating mga kamay, nails natin, kasi this is the most part of our body that is working a lot. Diba? Yung ating kamay ay lagi natin ginagamit sa ano pa mang bagay. Okay? Mapakain, mapalinis, at kung ano pa man. Even sa work natin. So, kailangan mag-practice natin ang frequent hand washing. Okay? Hand washing, the proper hand washing procedures. Para makaiwas tayo sa sakit. Na which is, nowadays ay talagang napakabilis ng pagkahawa ng sakit dahil sa kumakalat na COVID-19. So, siguraduhin na maging malinis. If you love your family, yourself, you need to take good care of yourself. Maging malinis sa pangangatawan. Okay. So, aside from that, wearing clean clothes is one thing to consider. Dirty clothes carry dirt and sweat. And of course, microorganisms dyan namamahay sa mga damit na hindi nalalaban ng maayos. Okay. So, body odor can also result from wearing dirty clothes. So, for example, once na nasuot nyo na yung damit ninyo, kahit palang dalian lang, you need to wash your clothes. Kasi, once na binilad nyo lang yan or pinahanginan nyo lang yan, ay yung bacteria na natili yan dun sa damit. Once na sinuot mo, matatransfer naman sa'yo yung bacteria. You must make sure that your clothes are washed after every use to remove the dirt, sweat, and microorganisms stuck to them. Then of course, wearing underwears like undershirts, boxer shorts, panties, and briefs are right next to our skin. So they collect sweat, dead skin cells, and body fluids. So, not enough na once ka lang nagpapalit ng underwear. Even twice or thrice magpalit ka ng underwears a day. Diba? Para hindi namamahay yung mga bacteria. So, especially naman kung wala kang enough na dami ng mga underwears, you can wash immediately yung inyong pinalitan. Diba? Wash nyo agad para sa sunod may masuot ulit. Hindi dahilan nyo masabing wala na po kasi. So, just allotting time para maglaba ng inyong mga underwears. These clothes must be washed after every use to prevent bacteria from multiplying on them. Ayan. Sometimes pa nga eh, ang alam ko, yung mga underwear na yan ay ina-iron, pinaplancha yun sa pinaka-middle part. Okay, sa may punja. Wherein yung mga garter rice, hindi. Kasi, syempre, pag once na pinalansya yung garter, yan ay luluwag. E, diba? Hindi nakakapit sa'yo. Ayan. So, that's all comprises on keeping good hygiene as the seventh element of healthy habit. I hope you have learned from our discussions or talk in this afternoon, pangarapians, and please, we are encouraging you to practice the 7 healthy habits for a better, a healthy living. Ayan. Maraming salamat po. And sa ating mga active viewers, thank you so much. Ingat-ingat po kayo. Thank you.